So now we're going to take a look at recording MIDI data. We're going to record MIDI into the playlist. After recording these MIDI patterns, you may notice that the timing is not quite right. So we will take a look at using quantization to ensure that all these patterns are grooving well with the arrangement.
All right, so let's now record some MIDI data. I'm going to select this track here, so the bass instrument is selected. And when I play notes on my MIDI controller, we can hear the bass. I do want to record from bar 5 onwards, so I'm just going to move this pattern over here to bar 5. I'll also lengthen it, because I know I'm going to record a 4-bar long pattern. This is not important. As long as you hit record, FL Studio will continue to record whatever notes you're playing until the point you stop. All right, I'm going to enable the metronome, so that way I can make sure to perform on time and match with the tempo of the project. I'll also turn on this option here, 3-2-1. This is a countdown option. And if I right-click here, I can change the number of bars for a countdown. I can set it to 2 bars, but I leave it at 1 bar. So I'll get a 1-bar countdown before the recording starts. All right, so my cursor is here on bar 4, so it's going to start recording from here. Well, first we'll hear 1-bar countdown and then start recording from here. All right, so I'm going to hit the record button now. And this pop-up appears that's asking us what we would like to record. So of all these options, what we're looking to record is MIDI data, and that falls under notes. So I'm going to select notes and automation. Now, I could have selected everything because that will just record everything and notes falls under everything. But since I know specifically I'm recording notes, I'll select notes and automation. All right, so everything is set and now all we need to do is hit the play button. All right, so I just hit the spacebar and we've stopped the recording process. Now the recording button is still lit, so as soon as I hit play or hit the spacebar, we will go back into record mode. If you don't like that, you can right-click here and select this option, disarm on stop. Or you can just click on the record button and get out of record mode. All right, so let's have a listen to what I just recorded. Playback from somewhere over here. All right, if I double click the pattern, we can see the notes that I played in. I may have played in too many notes here. Let me delete some of these. So right click on this one and right click on this one here. Now in terms of the timing of the performance, it's fairly decent, but if I zoom in, you will notice that some of the notes are early and some of the notes are late. We can address this with quantization. Now while recording, if the snap to grid option is set to any value aside from line, cell or none, FL Studio will automatically quantize to one of these options. So let's say if I set it to half beat, anything that I play will automatically be quantized to half a beat. Now I'm not a big fan of this feature. I like to just record freely and if there's any kind of a timing issue, I like to address it after the fact. And we can do that by opening up the quantization option. If I click this tool drop-down option, there's a quick quantize option. If I choose quick quantize, everything will be quantized to the current resolution. But I'm going to choose quantize. And that way we get a little pop-up that has a bit more features and settings related to the quantization. So right now it's set to step. The template is set to step. If I click over here, there's a huge collection of different options for quantization. I leave it at step. Start time. So we can choose to quantize the start time and we can choose to set how much we want to quantize the start time. And if you look carefully, as I'm adjusting this amount, you can see the notes are readjusting to be perfectly on the grid or at 0% being completely how I originally played it in. All right, so let's quantize this a little bit. Sensitivity refers to the window sensitivity of the notes it selects for quantization. So you can see over here, when the sensitivity is kind of low, it just skips that note altogether. All right, so I think these settings are fine, so I'll just hit accept. And now let's have a quick listen to this part. Play back from here somewhere. All right, so we've recorded some MIDI data and also looked at how to quantize it.